Hello students, today we'll see how we can use objects as parameter. So far we have been using normal data types like int, float, double, long, etc, like the parameters as the parameters. But in this case we have to see or we can learn how we can give objects as the parameter. And always remember one point, that objects are what? They are the instance of class. They are the variables of a class. What is class? Class is a non-primitive data type. Non-primitive data type means there are two types of data types, primitive and non-primitive. The primitive data types, you know, the basic data types like float, int, sort, double, long, byte, boolean, wagera, wagera. Non-primitive means the classes, the arrays, etc. So in this case, we'll see how we can use this class variable, the non-primitive data type, as parameter. So to understand this, this is one of the simple program which has been discussed in the previous class, and in this class I'll show you with the help of a program. I'll type this program for you, although it will take time, but it'll understand you, will become better. So this is the another set of program. This is the program which we saw in the last class. Today we'll see this code. Class object as parameter. And here we are making two variables, normal. Data section, we are defining two data variables, two data members with of int type, very simple. Now, this is constructor having two parameters. It's not the default constructor, it's just a constructor having parameterized constructor. This kind of constructor is called parameterized constructor. Look at this. This is the parameter, and this is the name of class. And have no return type, that means this is a constructor. If the name of class and name of function are same, then you have to understand that this is a constructor. And since it has parameter, so it is also known as parameterized constructor. Nothing big, no big deal, it's simple. Now you know why constructors are used, to give the initial value to the data members of that object. So you must also know this, because you have to always keep in your mind that whenever we create object, what happens with RAM? So make it RAM, it will be used afterwards when program will start executing. So right now what we are doing, A equals I and B equals J. Look at the way I'm writing. I'm written everything in the same line. This is the terminator. After terminator, we can start another set of statement, either in the same line or in the next line. So I'm doing the same line. So the task of constructor is over. Now what? One function is made equal to, and dot confuse yourself with the system defined function. This equal to function is user defined function. We are making, I will make, you can make. And this time, instead of this name, we'll give some other name just to show you. And yes, another chance to learn Boolean return. So far we have been using the numeric, or just normally numeric data types as the return type. This time we are using a Boolean data type for returning. The return type will be Boolean. I'm giving a function name E2 or EQ2 equal to for sort. And look, we could have given this kind of parameter, INTA or something like this, which that we normally give. But no, in this case, we'll give what? Object as the parameter. Object is what? The instance of a class, the variable of a class. What is the name of class? This is the name of class. Object as para, OB para. Yes. And any variable name, XYZ, just like we write int a, no, that's the same way we are writing this class name and this x. This will become more clear if you just practice it, huh? Now what? If Boolean is there, then of course there is the need of the if condition. If x means, for simplicity, let us give this name O so that you could understand it a better way. Problem O, give O. If O dot, it's not zero, it's O. If O dot A, O dot A means what? I'll make this point clear. So just relax and watch. Why simply A? I'll make this point also very clear. This is the logical AND operator, and a video is uploaded regarding this. So please watch the use of this. If this is the case, then what? Return true. You can write true in the parentheses, or you can simply write true like that. Else, otherwise, if this is the case, then do this. Otherwise, what? Otherwise, return false. Fine. This function is over. This much only. And this time, this class is also over. Fine. Now what? We'll make another class. Good name. Class pass object. Okay. In this case, it's using the capital letter, but I'm using a small letter. So you have to follow this small letter only. Now in this class, we are making the public main function, public static void main. On the formulated string args. Nice arrangement. Now you could understand. Fine. So what? Yes. String args. Look, dear students, why I'm doing this. I could have just told you that this is happening and all, but I'm demonstrating it for your betterment. So you also take care, you also practice. So, and this program can be only understood if you know the basics of object oriented, okay? So basics are used here. Look what is happening here. Test OB one. In this case, we have a given another name. OB para instead of test. What I'm doing here, I'm simply creating a variable OB1 of this class that we normally do using the new keyword which allocates a space. A test OB para. This is the constructor which I'm calling. Let us give the same data. So just with this line, if this line will be executed, then what will happen? Let us have a closer look. This is a RAM. When we use the new keyword, you know, the space is allocated. How much space will be allocated? What space will be allocated? Let us have a look. What we have created? We have created OB1. So we'll have OB1A. Why OB1A? Have a look. This is the class OBPara, and it has int A and B as the data members. So for each set of object, means for this object, or for this object, or for OB3, will have what? This arrangement. So OB1 dot A and OB1 dot Actually, I should have written this side. OB1.A. This is a space allocated. Let us assume that it is taking just 1 byte for the simplicity. OB1.B. So this is what happens. And since a parameterized constructor is given, so at the time of the creation of the variable A and B, at the same time, they will be initialized as well. How they will be initialized? Look, what is happening? I'm calling a constructor here. Look at the constructor. What is, for what it has been designed? So this is the constructor having two integer parameters. So what will do? A value will become I value and they will become J. What is the value phi in J? 122. So this case, what is happening? OB1.A has become 100 and OB1.B has become 22. So this is what will happen when this first line will be executed. So we have the another set of line in a similar way. OB2 equals new OB para. This time, again, the same set of data. So what will happen with this? The same thing will happen. In RAM, object 2 will be created, who's A, and object 2, B will be created. You know, every object you'll make, it will have its own set of data and functions. It is just like that has been told to you earlier in the object-oriented classes that class is a prototype. I mean, class is a blueprint, a class is a structure, class is a design of an object. And when we create object, it's instance of that class. In simple words, class is a kind of map. And according to that, one object is created. Think it in a similar way. Suppose we have to make a car, then to define a car, how the car will be, how many wheels will be, what the sitting capacity, how engine will work, how music system will work, how AC will work. That has been decided in the class while defining a class. And now when we create any object, that is one instance of that class. One car is created. One car is manufactured. It has its own set of seats, tires, engine, systems, lights, everything. The same way we are creating object 2 means another car. It will have its own set of everything. And this is what we are watching here. Object 2's A and object 2's B. Although they have same data, due to some reason it is there, we'll see this. Now OB3 also. Another car we are creating. OB3. It will have its own set of all the things. But this time what we are doing, simply having what data? -1 and -1 again. So can we give -1? Of course, it's an integer. We can give it. What is this? So let us create this also here. OB3.A and OB3.B. What's the value of OB3.A? -1. It is also -1. Why? Because it is provided here. You can change this set of data and see the difference while practicing. Now, look, this has been told to you that this kind of functions can be called in the println also. And this is the return type function. So this will return either true or false because it is a Boolean type. So we'll see the execution also, but let us first write the code. OB1 equals OB2. Is it equal? That will be decided by, look, this is just a message kind of thing. You might be watching, so we have written two equals, but why you have written single equal? Okay, no problem. Either you can write single or double, because in Java, we have two equality test, we have double equal to sign, so better to write this. So whether this is equal or not, that will be told by this function whether true and false. So OB, look at the way it is being called. This is the most important part of the program, the most important. So you need to take a good care. OB1 dot equal to, excuse me, it's not equal to. That's what I told you. This is not the user defined, a system defined function. What function name we have given? Look at the name of function, EQ2, EQTO. So this is the name that we have to follow. This is the function which we have made, EQ2, OB2. This OB2 is being passed as the what? The argument, the parameter. So before understand this program, you should be very clear and very clear with the functions with different set of data and parameter and all. So before you do this, you just make yourself clear in that part. Watch the previous videos and function more robot functions and all. So let us copy this, paste it and make some changes. It's now comparing whether object one is equal to object three or not. So here we just need to write OB3. Now what? Now that's it. Main function over and the class is over. Fine. Now we have already written this, so we could do like this. Once have a look over the program. Now, let us minimize it so that reducing the font size so that we could see maximum code in a single screen. Now we can see a complete program here. Okay, this is the RAM. We have seen what will happen. Now the CMD. Java. I've not yet saved it. Save it first. Control S. OBPara.java. Better to write one comment to show use of object as parameter. If anybody will open this program, then you might understand. Oh, this is the case. बहुत बढ़िया. ओके, रॉन्ग स्पेलिंग. लाइन नंबर 11. आई शुड हैव रिटन ट्रू बट इट्स समथिंग एल्स. TRUE. नाउ इट्स ओके. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम. जावा ओबी. नो, एक्सक्यूज मी वंस अगेन. In this case, we have two classes, OBPara and PassOb. I have given the name, any one name I can give this. But the main function exists in which class? This is one confusion that most of you might face while using multiple classes. So remember, dear students, that this has been told you in the last video also, but let us have a look. So I was trying to do something, but it's not working that way. So let us take. Okay, look at this. Where is the our program? Look, pass OB. And OB para. Yes. These two classes are created when we compile this. So we have main function in this particular class. So we have to call this class. I mean, we have to run this class, pass OB. It's showing true and false as expected. Now let us see in detail why this output. So it is now important to understand everything. We have seen the output. Look, student, what is happening? This line constructor is being called, the ob1.a and b that we just saw got their values, initial values. In this case also, ob2 has got this, ob3 has got their this hits value. Now what? Just want to show you the output. That's it. Now everything is there on the screen. Okay. So the main thing comes from here. OB1.EQ to OB2. What is this? Look, we are calling this function with the help of this object. Okay. So OB1 is calling this function. What is happening here? And look, OB2 is being passed. So whatever the value of OB2 is passed on to O. Why it is passed on? Because this is an object and this is O is also of same type. This is called pass by reference. The reference of OB2 is passed to this object O. Now this O object is referring this. Yes. OB O object. This O object is now referring this. This particular OB2. Why? Because this is the case. OB2 is passed to O. Now what? O dot A simply means OB2 dot A, any 100. O dot A or OB2 dot are same now because the reference is passed on to this O object. This happens. And this is the thing that you have to understand. Now, O dot A, what is the value of O dot A? This is 100. Now what is A? So A, there is no object. So what? So you have to see which object is calling this function. OB1 is calling this function. So simply writing A means what? OB1's A, this A, OB1A. The function, the object which is calling the function, its data members will be freely used there. So A, writing simply A means OB1.A. This, because OB1 is calling it this OB1.A. So what does this expression become? Is O.A. This means this. If this is equal to this or not. Yes, this is true. The first part is true. This is the AND logical AND operator. Both parts should be true in order to be overall true. Now O.B means what? Simply this 22. And simply B means what? OB1.B. This, both are same. So this is also true and this is also true. So the overall result is becoming true. And thus the case is returned true. So this true is returned here and this true is outputted that we saw in the on the output screen, true. In the second case, same thing is happening. This time we are calling OB1.EQ and this time we are passing OB3. Now what is happening? OB3 is passed on to O. This time, O is now not referring to this. So after the end of this function, I mean, when this function is called and when it is ended, everything gets flushed out from the memory. Memory becomes clear and clean. Now again, we are calling this and this time we are passing OB3. Now this time the object O will refer to this. This O is now referring this. And now the same thing is O dot A. O dot A means minus one. Is minus one